What's going on, gang? Bolt Matrix here, and today we are going to form Menasor. Now we have Lockdown, Decepticon Off-Road, Motormaster, Dead End, and Dragstrip. There is also a sixth member, which is the Blackjack?
Yeah, Blackjack
figure, but we'll get to him once we get him formed up. Now, one thing I do want to mention to all of you guys is in the directions for all of these figures, there's something interesting. There is a little picture of Menasor. And here's the picture. In this picture, you will notice they do not use Blackjack in the official picture. And in the official setup, we have Dragstrip and Dead End as arms, Off-Road and Breakdown as legs. So that's what we're going to start with. We're going to show you this setup first, and then we'll add Blackjack after we're done combining. But just showing you in the original, in the official Hasbro documentation, there's no extra figure there in the chest. Starting off with the legs, first off, this is going to be the easiest part. We're going to first take Breakdown, flip up the windscreen, take the front of the vehicle mode and flip that around, then reach underneath the figure and flip out the combiner peg, and that's pretty much it. Then all we do is add the combiner port. Now, according to the picture that I just showed you, this is the way that the figure is officially supposed to be. But in the directions, you will see that the undercarriage or underside of the vehicle mode is supposed to point forward, and what we think of the, as the heel is supposed to be the foot. Huh. So, according to the original picture we saw, this is what he's supposed to look like. But according to the directions, it's supposed to be this. Well, we'll take a look at both. Next up is Off-Road, and he's just as easy as Breakdown. Grab the front of the vehicle and do its transformation like you do for the vehicle or robot mode. Then just take the head and flip it around to flip up the combiner port and grab his gun and peg it down. And the legs are formed. Next up is Motormaster, and this is actually going to go pretty easily because we're only going to kind of do a half transformation. So flip down the components there in the front and fold them down. Take the legs and bring them down to form the hips. And then do a kind of a 180 here. Flip the inside of the legs and then click them out. One, two, three. And then bend them down. So one, two, three. The reason we do the three clicks is so that we get the knee to a almost 45 degree angle, so we can flip this inside flap up and peg it into the thigh. And that's supposed to, I don't know, keep the legs from moving, I guess. And unfortunately, you see how it kind of just doesn't line up correctly? I don't know why. It just doesn't on my figure. Just have to fiddle with it. And then we flip, come back to the top, flip open these sections and fold the arms up inside and peg them into place like so. Flip out the hands. Next, we open up the what will be the chest and flip out Menasor's head and give him some horns. And then we rapidly close the chest. Unfortunately, the chest doesn't really stay closed all that well. Just wiggles open. So, torso is ready. Next up are the arms. We'll start with Dragstrip. First, take the front of the vehicle mode and flip it back like this. Get the head out of the way. Twist it around and then fold it back down so it pegs into place. Oh, missed the peg. And flip the head back into the spoiler area. Take what the sides of the vehicle mode and they will become the arms, or what would be the arms in robot mode, and then point them to the sky, and then kind of fold them back in on the body as far as they'll go. Turn the forearms so that they're pointing towards the bottom of the vehicle mode, and then fold them in like that. And then you could flip out the combiner port, which is a lot harder to do than it should be sometimes, like that. And then extend the robot legs, turn them, so that you and then find the point where the knees bend, and then attach the hand unit and flip out the fingers. And we are good to go with this arm. Now for dead end, raise the gull wing bits, the back of the vehicle mode, flip out what are the legs in robot mode. Then this little gray piece in between, this gets flipped around, but be very careful. This has a tendency to pop off very, very easily. And then close that up, sandwich them together. Take the vehicle mode section and flip it up over the robot head, and then flip the whole section around and kind of just fiddle with it until it folds out of place, like breakdowns did. And then what I like to do with the arms is take them, turn them around, and then do the same thing that I did with Dragstrip, and do that with these arms. That's not really what's in the instructions, but it's what I like to do just to get them out of the way. And then rotate the bits around till you get the elbows, and then peg on the combiner port. And there we go. Next, we slide the torso onto the legs. Sorry, I just got a text. Like so. And now to attach the arms. Just drop them into place. Sometimes easier said than done, especially if you don't screw it up. When I combine them, I like to just put my finger over top. That way I have something, some leverage to push on. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present Combiner Wars Menasor? He is pretty darn cool. From the back, he looks kind of like a mess, but from the front and the sides, he is fantastic. Yeah, I do like Superion a little bit better. Superion's a little bit more cohesive, but I like what we have here. I really, really do. I think the only differences or only changes I would make would maybe do something a little bit with Dead End's hands there. Those look really out of place. But otherwise, I think what we've got here is really something awesome. I'm really looking forward to some of the other Combiner Wars figures that we've got coming up. So let's go ahead and add Blackjack real quick. Blackjack is added simply by opening up the chest, and there are two pegs, and just putting Blackjack on those two pegs like this. Now the figure does not stay, and there's a specific reason for that, which I'll show you here in just a second. But here is what Menasor looks like with Blackjack. And if I'm honest, I don't think that's much of an improvement. I like it the other way, personally. Now, the problem with Blackjack is that he does not stay connected to Menasor. And that's the reason is really kind of weird, and it's going to be hard to show, because if you look at the tip of my nail, and on this peg, the very top of the peg, there is a little nub, or a little raised section, about, I'd say maybe 5/16 of an inch, or maybe 10 millimeters in from the tip. And it's on all of these spokes. The way you fix it is you need to take a piece of sandpaper or an emery board and sand them down, because the holes on the bottom of Blackjack are just too small to fit these little raised bits. Now, this is the official way that Hasbro wants us to combine the figure. I'm not too thrilled with this combination, though. I like to see a little bit of a change. I would like Breakdown to be turned around. I would personally like Dead End to be a leg. And the reason for that is because I think the coloring that way works a little better. But first, we're going to flip the legs around. Now, personally, I think this looks a lot better. I think there's a lot more color going on, and it just looks better. It looks more like the G1 figure that I know and love. originally when I flip these around, the what are the spiky heels point forward, and that off balances the figure quite a bit. So in this case, I leave these engine components pointing forward with the single spike being the heel. I just think that works better. Now we could do one or two more things with these figures, and that's now we could do one more thing, and that's making the arms legs and the legs arms. So I'm going to show that to you right now. I think this way looks pretty cool also. This is pretty awesome. Now, you'll notice that I have the legs turned around so that the vehicle parts are pointing forward. That was just something I did just because I wanted to. You can, as I said earlier, easily just turn them around. It's not that big a deal, but with drag strip, you do have a little bit of a challenge with getting clearance of the head here. You can turn it around via the inside, though, like that. And then with dead end, you just twist it and it's done. So there is that. Now, I do like this way as well. I think either way is perfectly justifiable. And, well, let's just face it, Menasor is pretty darn awesome. Regardless. Now, we are getting an official Wild Rider that is going to be a remold of Dead End in these colors, or I should say the G1 Wild Rider colors. When that figure comes out, I will be reviewing it. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video review of Combiner Wars Menasor. As always, I have been Bolt Matrix. I ask you to like, comment, and subscribe, and please be sure to stick around for my next video review.